The Wheat School on realagriculture.com is brought to you by CNMC, Syngenta Canada, and the Alberta Wheat Commission.
Peter Johnson at Wheat Pete, realagriculture.com, and we are talking planting wheat. It's such a great start this year. September wheat, it was going in beautiful, the nicest conditions ever. We thought maybe we'd set a record wheat acreage in the province of Ontario, and then, doggone it, it starts to rain. So now it's Thanksgiving weekend. It's getting late in a fair bit of the province, and we still want you to plant wheat because wheat can still do really great, and it has great soil health benefits and all those other things. And by the way, the price is really good right now too. But we want you to grow really high yielding wheat, even though it's getting late. So what are the management things that you need to look at in order to do that? So first off, we want to plant into fit conditions. Now you all know that I'm Wheat Pete, but I used to be Peter No-Till. I do not like tillage. Man, if that ground isn't fit and you've got two or three good days and you can just tickle that ground with a little tillage and plant into nice dry ground, I have edible bean guys who in the morning will pull the edible beans but not windrow, because just driving through with the knife on that edible bean machine will dry out that soil surface, and they'll windrow the edible beans in the afternoon so that the windrow goes on dry ground. A little light tillage, not deep, not massive, a little light tillage if you have to in order to get the ground fit. We want fit conditions if we can get there. Next, seeding depth. For goodness sakes, do not go shallower. Everybody says, go shallower, get it out of the ground faster. Right, go shallower and let it all frost heave next March. Don't do it. Stay inch and a quarter, inch and a half, maybe even inch and three quarters, but don't go shallower. Phosphorus, of course, I'm the poster child for phosphorus with wheat. Phosphorus with wheat. If you can't do it with the drill, put it down the pipe with the seed, then broadcast some phosphorus. Unless your soil test is really high, later planted wheat needs phosphorus. So seed placed if you can, broadcast if you can't, but make sure you get the phosphorus there. And last thing you want to do, up the population. We are not going to get many tillers. Oh gosh, if you're in Essex County, October the 10th is your sweet spot. So you're 1.8 million, it's clay soil, 1.6 million, because you've got enough heat to get tillers. But once you get to London and from there north and east, we're not going to get many tillers. So all of a sudden, I almost can't put enough wheat seed on. At least 2 million seeds per acre, maybe 2.1, 2.2. Yeah, it gets a little expensive, but man, you need those heads if you're going to have big wheat yields. And don't forget, fall weed control. If you didn't burn it down with a glyphosate Aragon, something to control the glyphosate resistant fleabane, the wheat emerges, even in this early wheat. You haven't put a herbicide on, fall herbicides work. So you can use Infinity FX, you can use Bactrolem, you can use Infinity. There's many options to get fall weed control, so the dandelions and the chickweed and all those other rotten things don't beat us up. So there you go. Easy to still grow great wheat, and we want you to plant wheat. Just make sure you use those management techniques, because Johnson wants you to grow great wheat.